Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to tell you how you can write algorithms for matrix addition and subtraction. So first I am going to write algorithm for matrix addition, then I will tell you how easily you can convert that algorithm for matrix subtraction. So if you want to add two matrix and you want to write their algorithm, so we need these parameters. So name of algorithm is matrix addition. First parameter is first matrix, then second matrix. So these two matrix will be added and their result will be stored into C matrix, R1 and C1. So this is row and column for first matrix, and this is row and column for second matrix. So before starting of addition, we just need to check the row and column values so that we can decide whether they are equal or not. So if rows and columns of both the matrix are equal, then only we can perform matrix addition, otherwise. So now we need to start this. So step number one is begin. Step number two, so here we can write if condition. So if R1 not equals to R2 or C1 not equals to C2. So if any one of the condition is true, like row of first matrix is not equals to row of second matrix, or column of first matrix is not equals to column of second matrix. So in both the cases, we cannot perform matrix addition. So here you can write print addition not possible and exit, right? So if this condition is true, then this message will be printed and your algorithm will be terminated here only. And you can also write any other message that you want to display. Now step number three. So if this condition is false, then we can perform matrix addition. So for that purpose, we need to implement a loop. So I am writing repeat for I equals to 1 to R1. So here we need to repeat the loop for rows and columns. So you can use R1 or you can use R2. Because if this condition is false, it means R1 is equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2. So you can use R1 or R2 in case of this loop. Now you need to apply one more loop. So repeat for J equals to 1 to C1. So here in case of second loop, you can use C2 as well, right? Now inside this loop, you can write of ij equals to a of ij plus b of ij. So this way ij indexes of a matrix will be added to ij index of b matrix and the result will be stored at c. Then we can write end of loop. So this is for this loop. Then again you can write end of loop. So this is for this loop. After completion of both the loops, you can write end. So this way all the indexes of A and B matrix will be added into the result will be stored in C matrix. So by implementing a function for this algorithm with the help of C or any other language, so in that case, the result will be available into C matrix. So either you can print that matrix or you can use that matrix for any other calculation, right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can write algorithm for adding two matrix. Also, we check the condition like for both the matrix, row and column should be equal so that we can perform the addition. Now, if you want to apply subtraction operation, so you just need to remove this plus sign with minus. and wherever we have mentioned addition, you can replace that X with subtraction. And rest of the things will be same, because in case of subtraction, we just need to subtract two numbers, like we added two numbers. So this way, I hope you understood how we can write algorithms for matrix addition as well as for matrix subtraction. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more algorithm related videos, so you can go to description of this video, and there you will find links of our playlist. So you can follow those playlists so that you can understand data structure. Thank you for watching this video.